So you see, there are times where the one who is getting into the relationship with another man's wife is the one that suffers. Then there are times you, who has a spiritual marriage, is the one that will suffer.
Okay, so in the instance of
Sarah didn't suffer. Yes, it was Abimelech that had the problem.
Now you're saying, man of God, that
there is also the situation where the one who is married to another in a spiritual marriage
is the one who suffers the repercussions.
Who suffers the repercussions for thinking to take a decision to marry another. So somebody say, okay, me, I have spiritual marriage. If you come and marry me and you suffer, it's your own problem. There are situations that you who has that spiritual spouse will suffer for thinking to take a decision physically to marry somebody physically. And that is what we see in Hosea chapter 1, Hosea chapter 2, and Hosea chapter 3. In the book of Hosea chapter 1, verse 2, he said, the beginning of the word of the Lord by Hosea, and the Lord said to Hosea, go, take unto thee a wife of whoredoms. What does it mean? Take a woman that is connected with many and marry her. He said, and have children of whoredoms. For the land had committed great whoredom, departing from the Lord. So this is somebody who is already in a married situation with a spirit being, this time the Lord, and is intending or has intended to dump his Lord to marry another. So now watch it this way. This is the Lord. He's married to Israel. And Israel is contemplating, or Israel has dumped his Lord for another. Then God said, Hosea, I want you as a prophet to enter into a certain prophetic act as a communication to Jezreel, which is Israel, in their fall.
Okay.
Anytime Israel was referred to as Jezreel, it actually meant Israel had broken pact and covenant with God.
Okay.
So Israel is actually the nation that is in covenant with God.
Yes.
The moment that people break covenant with God, they are referred to as Jezreel. That was just by the way.
Yes.
But that is also very informative for somebody who is reading the scriptures to understand when Israel is used and when Jezreel is used.
Okay.
Now, so he went and took Gomer, the daughter of Diblaim, which conceived and bare him a son. And the Lord said unto him, call his name Jezreel, for yet a little while, and I will avenge the blood of Jezreel upon the house of Jehu, and will cause to seize the kingdom of the house of Israel. So watch this. As a result of this action, God is saying that a whole kingdom will come to a halt. Now, after this verse 4, we now move to Hosea chapter 2, the verse number 1. He says, say ye unto your brethren, Ami, and to your sisters, Ruhama, plead with your mother, plead, for she is not my wife, neither am I her husband. Let her therefore put away her whoredoms out of her sight. The very woman that Hosea the prophet married in chapter 1. In chapter 2, Hosea is calling for the sons to talk to their mother, and that their mother is not her wife, and he, Hosea, is not the husband. But then they were still in the physical context of marriage. But in the actual sense of the word, Hosea was not the one married to this woman, but they had children. Now hear what he says. He said, let her therefore put away her whoredoms. So until this lady in question divorces the husband to get married to Hosea without any contact with the spirit being, Hosea says, your mother is not my wife, neither am I her husband. There are many marriages. I don't even want to go into that. Before people begin to take grounds and say, I'm divorcing you. You are actually not married in the first place. You're only living with another man's wife or another man's husband. Then the word of God says, and her adulteries from between her breasts. Watch this. This is to the woman who is in that situation. of whoredoms.
Yes.
He said, lest I strip her naked. So you see, you are now also about to suffer for being in a spiritual marriage. He said, and set her as in the day that she was born, and make her as a wilderness, and set her like a dry land, and slay her with thirst. So somebody in a spiritual marriage, herself or himself, can die. And please watch this. This is God who is now about to strike. He said, lest I strip her naked, set her as in the day that she was born, make her as a wilderness, set her like a dry land, and slay her with thirst. And I will not have mercy upon her children. So you see, your father or mother is in a spiritual marriage. You can suffer for it if you don't rise up to handle the case for your father or for your mother. He said, for they be the children of whoredoms. That spirit being can attack that woman and attack the children that have been born as a result of that physical union.
Because in the mind of that spirit being,
yes,
the illegal union is your father and your mother.
Yes.
And not actually the spirit being that is
exactly.
My your mother.
Exactly. The illegal union is you as a coming as a result of the union between your father and your mother, or your mother and your father, and can strike that your father or mother who is legally married to him or her, that spirit being, and come as far as to strike you as a child. So this is a family matter. It is a matter that calls for father, mother, and children to come together and say, who has a spiritual marriage in this house? We must attend to it. Because in the context of Abimelech, his other wives that were not in room with her, suffered for it.
Yes.
Not only his wife, all women under her covering suffered for it. And then Abimelech himself suffered for it. In the context of Hosea, the woman who Hosea was married to was now at the brink of death, and her children as well. And this time, Hosea the prophet is sitting down there watching. Hear what God says. He said, for their mother had played the harlot, so that she that conceived them had done shamefully. For she said, I will go after my lovers that give my bread and my water, my wool and my flax, my oil and my drink. Pastor, there are spiritual marriages that are contracted. I will be talking about them. Now, in the Hosea sense, it is called the cult spiritual marriage.
The cult.
Cult, C-U-L-T. There are spiritual marriages that are contracted so that the person that is married to the spirit being can prosper. So the spirit being is married to this person in order to help the person physically. So assuming the person is doing business, the spirit being will prosper the person physically, because he's actually taking care of his wife spiritually and is reflecting physically. So the woman said, I'll go back to my former lovers. What were they providing? In the verse 5, see what he said. He said, for their mother had played the harlot, she had conceived them that had done this shamefully. For she said, I will go after my lovers, not my lover Hosea, that give me, you see, my bread. So that spiritual lovers, or those that are not part of the physical union that we here as let me call it mortal beings recognize, but those on the other side of the spirit were the ones that were providing this woman bread, they were providing her water, they were providing her wool, they were providing her flax, they were providing her oil, they were providing her drink. So you are a young man, you are a young woman, you have seen this young guy that is prospering, he's making it, he has a car, he's the boss at the workplace, everything, he has a nice house, he's well to do. Then your eyes, you want such a man, you want such a woman, but you don't know what is engineering the prosperity.
Mercy.
You don't know what is behind that kind of success.
Oh,
and so there are lots of people. That's how come I said we must do full disclosure. If you're a father and a mother and your son brings, the first question to ask is not where do you work. Those are unnecessary questions. The first question to ask your son or your daughter who brings another lady home, it's not who is your father and who is your mother. Those are unnecessary questions.
Off track.
Because if you win in the spirit, you can finish up also in the flesh. But if you start, and that's what most of us do. We never do any prayers of inquisition.
Mercy.
We never inquire of the Lord. Who is this that is coming into my home? Who is this that my daughter is bringing here? What is behind him? What has prospered him? So for you, you saw this in-law to be, he's a doctor. He has accolades, certificates. He's made it in life. He's actually the branch manager of probably ADB or Zenith Bank or... Oh!
Nice one.
You don't know what has...
No, man of God, the thing is, I mean, if you think of somebody having spiritual marriage, the kind of imagery you're having in your mind is somebody who is impoverished, someone Pastor, who's been pulverized.
Some people prosper by their spiritual marriage. Some people, that is why the spirit is angry, that after all that I have done for you, you want to jolt me and dump me.
I'll show you Pepe.
And I will show everything that comes out as a result of that relationship you want to go into. So it is a jolting. You see the thing? So you just don't damp the spirit. That's how come I said some people's decision to go for deliverance.
Like the comments the gentleman gave, that he took, the friend took their girlfriend for deliverance.
And he suffered madness for it. She suffered madness for it. He took a lady, probably somebody is relating a story to you that she has spiritual marriage, so you should help the person. And then you take it to an inexperienced pastor or a man of God in the deliverance ministry who is not well versed in the matter of spiritual marriage. Then the person lays his hands, I break. And we'll see whether it is all by I break. We'll look at that way of ministration today. And if that's all that it matters, pastor, some people can become worse. And it was Jesus who said it. He said that there is a man who has a spirit dwelling with him. The spirit is cast out. The spirit goes to roam about and decides to come back fortified. Coming back, seeing that the house has been swept, it goes back, gets 7 more wicked spirits, return back to the house. And hear what Jesus said. He said, and the state of that man is worse off than the first.
He says that then he goeth out in Luke chapter 11 verse 26. Then he goeth out and taketh to him 7 other spirits,
more wicked than himself.
And they enter in. And dwell there. And the last state
of that man
is worse than the first.
So do you see that Abimelech got sick?
Yes.
Because he was trying to touch somebody's wife.
Yes.
Do you also see that the woman who Hosea, the woman of whoredoms, who Hosea got married to, was now going to suffer repercussions based on her intention to get married or settled with Hosea?
Yes.
So it is neither here nor there. You don't even know the situation you are entering into.
Pastor, from this scripture, it indicates in the Matthew scripture, it indicates that a person could even be properly married to more than one spirit entity.
Oh, yes. I've had situations where people are married to 4 spiritual beings who come, all 4 come together to sleep with her in one dream in the night. All 4. There is a nested spiritual marriage. Like polygamous spiritual marriage. It is there. Just as it is here in the physical, where we have bigamy and polygamy, it's also the same thing in the spirit realm. It's just like that. He said, for their mother had played a harlot. He said, I will go after my lovers that give me bread, water, wool, flax, oil, and my drink. Therefore, behold, I will hedge up thy way with thorns and make a wall that she shall not find her paths, and she shall follow after her lovers, but she shall not overtake them, and she shall seek them, but shall not find them. Then shall she say, I will go and return to my first husband, for then was it better with me than now. For then it was better with me than now.
Means her state now is worse.
Worse off because of that decision. For she did not know that I gave her corn, I gave her wine, I gave her oil, I multiplied her silver and gold, which they prepared for Baal. So you, God, Adonai, Yahweh, has prospered you, and you are taking her things and you are going to give it to Baal. No. He said, because of this, I'll rid you and make you naked, everything that I did for you. And don't only see it as, but this is God. No, it's a spiritual principle. Mm-hmm. So we are looking at a being that has prospered its own. Probably this being has taken care of this girl that was betrothed. I'll talk about the contracts of spiritual marriage. That was betrothed to it right from childhood. Has taken care of this girl and followed up, making sure she's passing all her exams. She's brilliant. She's a shark. This spirit being is supplying her with everything that she would need, because to the spirit being, this is his wife. And so she's taking care of the girl. The girl now grows up and decides that he's not going to worship the spirit being or succumb to the spirit being again. He's found this guy who is on earth and who is nice, who speaks to her heart. And she thinks that she's come of age to marry. And so physically she wants to get settled and marry. But she's forgotten that spiritually she's married to another. So she tries it. The spirit being says, hey, so for all that I have done for you, you want to leave me and get married to a physical boy or a physical girl? I will destroy you. I won't touch the person you want to get married to. I will touch you. You are the one I would hit hard. And so everything that the spirit being has given to the person or aided the person to get comes to a square one.
Pastor Obed, always a blessing.
I'm very excited to let you know that by the special grace of God,
okay,
I put together a material on everything that I know on spiritual marriage. It is all about spiritual marriage. That is my latest book. It is not bragging. There is no book on earth like this book. I am not bragging. On the matter of spiritual marriage, nothing has been written. What has been particularly done is prayer topics. But to go into the matter, there is virtually no material apart from looking into the scriptures, the Bible.
Okay.
There is no material that exposes the kingdom of darkness,
okay,
on spiritual marriage.
All right.
As this book.
That means that there's a novel material.
It's
that
a novel material.
You must get for yourself. You must get it for your friends. You must get it for your family members, your loved ones. Anyone that you know that is connected to you that is experiencing this plague in any dimension, this is a must-have. You should place in your order now. Wherever it is that you are around the various nations of the world, you can send in your WhatsApp message now. Make your WhatsApp call now. Call in 024-703-6 136 and place your order.